Hello everyone, and welcome to the 9:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. session of the 2019 Open Simulator Community Conference. In this session, we are happy to introduce a presentation which is called Eureka World, an Ecosystem for Learning. Our speaker is Ori Shapira, aka Tor Zane. Please check out the website found at conference.opensimulator.org for speaker bios, details of sessions, and the full schedule of events. Now, a little bit of background for you. Ori is the founder, CEO, and head of pedagogy, and tech of Eureka World, a learning open simulator virtual world used in 150 schools in Israel. And it's used to provide a world of creation and shared learning using three-dimensional multi-user worlds, which are combined with physical interfaces, things like 3D printers, robotics controllers, VR headsets, and much more. This provides quality integration of learning patterns for students in the 21st century and has been implemented to exciting success for the third consecutive year in the education system. And for specifics of these projects, please see https://www.eurekaworld.co.il. Now, this session is being live streamed and recorded, so if you have questions or comments during the session, you may send tweets to @OpenSimCC and use the hashtag #OSCC19. Welcome, everyone, and let's begin the session.
Hi, and thank you. So, again, as it was mentioned, I am Ori Shapira, and we're going to speak about educational ecosystem inside a virtual world. A few very short words about myself. I'm coming from 30 years of internship in the high-tech environment, mainly in edtech technologies, and in the last 10 years, I'm focusing on virtual world technologies and the development of 3D, 3C environment. We will speak about it in a second. So first of all, what is this 3D, 3C talking about for those who don't familiar with this definition? I took it from Professor Yesha Sivan. He's a professor here in Israel who investigated a lot about virtual worlds. And I thought this definition is accurate and help us to build the education system. It means that it's 3D environment, of course, a multiplayer community environment, a creation place where people can create actually the space that they are live in, and commerce. There is a commerce rules around, of course. Open Simulator is one of the leading 3D 3C environment, but we took this in conception and put it into education environment. So the first thing was that we understood that the 3D environment is not only on the screen, and we combined an Arduino controller and video work, and of course AR and VR into the system, 3D printing and additional EEG and physical device into our work. I will do a 1 minute explanation about 3D printing and Arduino to explain the way we are think and work with education system. So, for example, with this vehicle, the student is building the vehicle inside Word and make it a vehicle with the programming and everything. And after they completing the project, we actually 3D printing it into the real life and start discuss about strengths of materials and how axis actually works, and how wheels is turned around, and so on and so on. So they actually have the full experience of making and real life design, and not only staying in the computer arena. Another issue is the Arduino controller. It can be actually a bunch of different programming controllers, but we are talking about Arduino. So the students can build a wind vane, either with 3D printing or carpenter or whatever in class, and then connect it through Arduino controller to the computer, to the Eureka World, and actually doing a sales raid in class based on the wind outside the class. This kind of combination, we are talking about the full 3D, 3C environment. We are also looking at the video. I will do a very short issue. Of course, video is a very common issue in virtual world, but we are talking about videos that the students create as part of the creation process inside world or bring it from the outside. Oh, now I go back. So, you can see, our vision is to create a human companionship in enrichment environment, how we can actually integrate human action in the education process inside world. We already mentioned it, few words about Eureka World, and we are going to, straight to the ecosystem issue. So by now we have 14,500 students and teachers in the system. We are working with over 150 schools, mainly in Israel, but also a few schools in USA and Ukraine. Already 330 teachers in Israel learn how to teach, build, and learn inside virtual world. There are three municipalities, big municipalities in Israel, that are taking part in our ecosystem, four NGOs, and of course the Ministry of Education. And we actually talking about any kind of pedagogic approach that can be implemented inside the world, starting with the PBL, project-based learning, and going to the problem-based learning, role-playing, learning by creation, of course, gaming, simulation, and MOOC. So what is all about, or what is the all excitement about ecosystem? The idea behind the ecosystem is that all the parts of the education system taking part in creating education in 3D, 3C, and help each part to make it better. So actually, the effort to make education in virtual worlds or 3D, 3C become easier because each part is helping to the other parts to push it further. So this is the ecosystem that we are talking about. It's of course combined schools, teachers, students, municipalities, academic institutes, the government or the Ministry of Education, commercial companies who serve the education, the non-profit organization, and of course the parents, and some kind of research. I will do very briefly a little bit about how we implement on each level our ecosystem, and I hope it gives you a good idea of what we are doing. So first of all, let's speak about the schools. Okay, the students actually sitting in school, but we supply to the school the option to make it, to change the way they are teaching as a school. What you can see here is it's a very unique project about Jerusalem in Israel. We worked on it for 6 months with 18 students inside school. And at the end of the day, all school played and learned about Jerusalem through the 3D environment, through the open simulator. We are talking about 300 students that actually learned inside the platform. And it's keep going even today, and this school is actually one of the leading in Israel, which each student from fourth grade to sixth grade is learning in virtual world. This is another way that a teacher inside school developed a game in Eureka World, teaching the part of the Bible, and it's become part of the everyday learning inside school. Of course, in order to do this process, we must have the teachers with us, and this will be my main focus in this presentation. First of all, we developed a full new management system focusing on teachers, which include bulk registration, which means that the teacher can register all his class at once and control their password and username. They can have a management tool that allow them pull students to a certain place inside the grid, so they have a little bit control about the student. They have the ability to change student permissions through a web interface and control better their class. They have a full statistics system that tell them which student spend how much time in which assignment, and again, they can know the data and keep the learning process. They can upload the objects straight from the website into their island, group management, and can update content inside the PRIMS through a website. This management system was a very first breakthrough that once we approach it with teachers, they start actually work inside the world. We also made the educators surprise bag, a bunch of components that allow them to very easily build educational stuff inside world, treasure hunt, puzzle, and so on. Okay, and we developed a vast tutorial at the Help Center, including a very detailed walkthrough for teachers and students how to work in the environment. And most important, in-world online training that we are keep doing. So far, 330 teachers already made it, and we have every week 1 hour support hour for each teacher who wants to ask questions. We also supplied them a way to build a very heavy curriculum, but also gain money or revenue out of that when they are selling it for other schools. Okay. The next step was the students, and I become a little bit short of time. The main issue with students is to make them create inside world. You can see here work of students in fifth and sixth grade in different projects that they are actually part of their curriculum inside schools. And we offer them a learning by gaming, again, inside the same platform. What you see here is a race game that they need to, like a survival, that they need to solve a lot of problems in order to get to the final stage. The municipalities. Two approaches that we are working with municipalities. One is a combine and save resources for a lot of schools, and the other one is a really big project based on a collaborative between different schools in the city. One of the projects, for example, is Haifa game, which is a Haifa model. It's one of the big cities in Israel. It was built actually by 10 different schools with 170 students from different schools working together on the same region, and by that creating a full city identification. The same project is now done in another city here in Israel. We also succeed to gather three main colleges in Israel who actually doing a teacher training. Beit Berl, for example, is one of them. They're actually doing some of the practice of new teachers inside the virtual world, so that those teachers, when they come to school, they're only already familiar with the approach and the idea behind it. And few words about the Ministry of Education. The Ministry of Education in Israel acknowledge the potential that come inside virtual worlds. And today he sponsored the teachers training, give the developing budget for new educational program, and of course give the acknowledgement for schools to work in this environment and to move forward. One of the important things, and this will be my last slide, and I will open it for a Q&A, will be working with NGOs who are working with the education system and allow them to build their own educational programs inside the Eureka World. Here you see a set. It's one of the biggest NGOs in Israel working in education and combined forces in order to push the idea behind the virtual world. And the most important issue is to build the community and the hackathons and special days behind that combine all the teachers in the environment for one effort. I will skip that one, and almost in time, I'm ready for question if there are any.
All right, let's see if there's any in chat. Any questions, please put them in local chat. Yeah, Lux is mentioning this is very impressive. Okay, we have one from Alan Scott. Is this over the internet or LAN? Are there no restrictions from IT departments like in European or US schools?
First of all, yes, it's over the internet, and the server, our servers are hosting in Amazon. We worked very hard to work through the security issues, and we have solution for that. We are probably can now work in any legal issues all around Europe. We support the Europe standard for security and privacy, and we need to do a lot of changes in the Open Simulator regular structure to support this level. But we are working in the secured environment for the Ministry of Education in Israel.
Okay. And also we got a question here from Eileen O'Connor asking, how do you get the teachers to buy into it? And kids under 13 was another one from Alan.
First of all, about kids under 13, I will not put a lot of effort inside. If you have more questions, approach me, but we not collect any information, identity information, and we secure the content inside our world. And the other question was about...
The teacher buy-in, how you get the teachers to buy into using the virtual worlds.
As I mentioned, this is the whole idea behind the ecosystem. We are pushing them, the Ministry of Education supporting us, some of the municipalities supporting us, and they are gained a very good training, starting from 30 to 60 hours of training, how to teach and how to build inside virtual worlds. And we have now a very strong community of teachers that working in Open Simulator for more than 3 years, so they can support each other. We have in some schools, four, five, six teachers that all of them working together on virtual world. This is the idea behind the ecosystem idea.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. And there's a couple other questions there, too, that you might want to talk with them about it afterwards, especially about the ministries of education. If you can just look at those tour in local chat for after as well. Well, thank you very, very, very much, Ori Shapira, for a terrific presentation. As a reminder to our audience, you can see what's coming up on the conference schedule at conference.opensimulator.org. And following this session, the next session will begin at 10 a.m. in this keynote region, and it's entitled Going Underground, Wrapping Tunnel in OpenSim. Also, we encourage you to visit the OSCC19 Poster Expo in the OSCC Expo 3 region to find accompanying information on presentations, and explore the Hypergrid Tour resources in OSCC Expo 2 region, along with the sponsor and crowdfunder booths located throughout all of the OSCC Expo regions.